everybody. I'm MiMiLock, and this is my review of Red vs. Blues in 15 episode 10, Battlescars. Let's read this description, and then we'll be on our way to the recap. Agents Carolina and Washington have successfully followed the trail of missing freelancers to the beach house of a former associate, Agent Illinois. While digging through their past hasn't yielded any revelations, it has managed to reopen old wounds for Carolina. So I expected to see Illinois in the episode, but I guess I was mistaken. I thought it would be somewhat of a remember the new guy scenario where there's a new guy and they talk about him, except no one's met him before and you know until the episode. But he's always existed because he was here the whole time, right? And there's nothing to go against that. But that didn't happen, and I'm gonna say exactly what happened right now during the recap. So Washington, Carolina show up at the beach house owned by Agent Illinois. Apparently, all the freelancers were kind of close when they, you know, weren't on the battlefield always, you know. They had fun out of armor, and I think that's something that's great. Illinois and York were drinking buddies, apparently, which reopens an old wound for Carolina. She still has York's lighter. Loyal. It's the only thing she has left of Project Freelancer, besides herself and Wash, who are literal living proof, but whatever, right? As she tries to throw it into the ocean, Wash stops her and gives some motivational crap. Not motivational, that's not what the word is. Just saying something, a quote that I can't remember. I do remember what it was now. You don't have to destroy the past to have a future. That's what it was. Also, car wash teasing. If you don't know what car wash is, it's Carolina and Washington, so car wash. It's a good ship, and I don't mind it, but I prefer platonically like Bumblebee and Ruby. So Wash gets the idea to turn on their freelancer recovery beacons so they can lure the freelancer killer to them. Temple explains everything that's happened because the Reds and Blues and Blues and Reds found the beacon and actually made their way to Washington, Carolina. So Temple explains everything that's happened while Washington, Carolina had been gone. Apparently, according to Temple at the time, the UNSC has been killing freelancers, not another person or organization. So then Temple, you know, kind of gets Washington, Carolina away from the Reds and Blues and Blues and Reds to show them a room of supposed freelancer armor replicas. Except they aren't replicas. And the suits of armor aren't empty. Turns out Temple's been killing freelancers by locking their armor to the point where they're immobilized. Then he locks Carolina in Wash's armor, and that's the end of the episode. What an evil dude. That's the recap, now for my final thoughts. So Temple's been suspicious and kind of dickish since episode 9, which is exactly why I didn't expect him to actually be a bad guy, so I hope this will unfold into more stuff later on, and it, you know, comes to light that he's actually not doing all this. Because we can't have another sociopath. Min and Felix were enough. Do you think we need Temple right now, too? Also, I forgot to mention this in my reaction, but Illinois's armor kind of looks like the metal armor in a way. Not saying it is the exact armor, but there's probably a reason why they didn't show the meta armor in this season. It's because in Halo 5, it just doesn't look good. So maybe that could have been it. Then again, I don't play Halo, so I have no idea. Yeah, guys, that was my review. Hope you enjoyed. Please like if you did. And subscribe if you want more of these reviews. Which will come weekly, always. Sundays. My reaction will be up shortly after this. And with that being said, I'll see y'all very, very soon. Sayonara.